Do you want to? I want to change the things that I do.
The tower blocks and suburbs of Britain are home to a unique music scene, which for some offers an alternative to a life of crime.
I'm trying to stay away from drugs and fucking theft and robbery and all those things there, man, because I ain't about to prison, man. I've got too much of a time, I've got too much to say for my ass to be back inside there, man.
These estates are home to thousands of dreamers. Music promises an escape.
Every year I go to jail as if I fucking love it. I don't get bail because I even tried to sell the judge shit.
Out of a million sad stories that you'll hear from people around here, you'll hear 10 successful stories, you know? So it's like 10 in a million is gonna make it around here.
Sloth and Skinny Man have both been in prison. For them, music is a way of avoiding going back inside. The choices they make will decide whether they fall back into a life of crime or end up signing a record deal.
I've been a good boy anyway this year. I'm a good boy. Wore gloves and all the jobs. I'm joking.
Meet MC Sloth, Elvis Inavisu. He's decided to put a life of crime behind him to concentrate on making music.
I was 11 the first time I actually got arrested, and then it started escalating. And by the time I got 14, I got arrested for GBH with a tent. I stabbed some geezer in Camden.
Sloth has been in serious trouble with the law for most of his life.
By the time I got to 15, I got arrested for burglary. 16, got arrested again for GBH, stabbed like two guys down in Old Street. Went to prison for 2 years, come back out. And now I've just been released again on bail for 5 more charges. I promised myself, yeah, and I'm determined this year, like, to get away from the ghetto life, like the drugs, like the violence, like the robbery. I'm not into that madness no more, yeah. Like, this year is my year for music. I've never really said to myself, I've never been determined and adamant to actually set out and achieve it. But now this year, like, I've promised myself, yeah, and all like the close people around me that I will like do something with myself this year. So many people that I know that are weak, but that's how I know I'm strong. Like, I'm still here. I'm still doing the same thing. And I've got people looking to kill me, but you know, I just had a message on my phone, man, saying you're dead.
You tell your manager that he's not going to have no one to sign any contracts after Friday, because you'll be gone, you cunt.
See what I'm saying? People like that. That's what I'm saying. Stupidness.
Sloth has to leave his violent past behind. Jail isn't the only thing that could cut short his musical career. Last night he was stabbed when three armed men kicked in his door looking for drugs and money.
They were my lady friend rolling a spliff. And we hear the door go.
Right, so I must hear the door go, so I say, is that the door? She says, yeah, so I've got to about here now, and I just hear the door. Like three men have run up the stairs, come on towards me. One of them's holding brandishing a stick, pointing at me, boy, get in there, masked up. Now one's got a gun, stick, the other one's got a knife, and the guy like back's got like a little rounds back. So like comes up, he's like, where's the shit, where your thing, blah blah blah. I'm like, boy, like it's my girl's yard, I ain't got nothing. Like, I'm coming in, like, one of them's giving me a dig before I got in here. They're screaming by now, like, at first I was like, be calm, babe. Like she was screaming all that, got like emotions all over the place. The dude who's got the chips come over and held me. And like, he's standing there, the dude with the bat's gone in, like he's rinsing out everywhere in the flat, trying to look through his shit. And then the geezer holding the stick must have like given my little brother back home. So I couldn't take it, I just like, I didn't see danger, I just like gone moved towards him. And like, I started like scrapping him with him. As I went towards him, like I felt like two like punches to my back. I thought they were just punches, like done it again, but at the time I didn't know I'd been stabbed. Get pulled back, like this dude takes the chiv, gives me one in the stomach. I was like, no, he just like give me some slices. Like, he was holding me back, and then as I broke out, I was scrapping with him again. Like, I think he was trying to give me a cut in the boat, like, cut my hand. And then, like, they must have seen the carrot and shit, and they kicked, got what they came for, and they went. I'm lying there in blood, my girl's screaming. Next thing I know, woke up, lost a few pints of blood. Like, I won't wish that I'm a worst enemy, man. It's like, it's bad. But, and that, like, the thing, I've done managed like that. I've gone into people who fucked around with me when their girls are there. And it's just like, rah. It's like, now I actually know how that guy felt and how his girl must have been feeling when I was doing the mad things I was doing. So it's just like, it's the circle of life, man. What goes around comes around. There it goes.
Another rapper, Skinny Man, is also caught between a criminal past and a musical future. He did have a record deal, but lost it while serving a 9-month sentence for dealing weed. He's just been released on probation.
It's a good feeling, you know what I mean? I've only just got back and I'm buzzing already. No prison screws around, no jingling keys. It's a good look.
Every time he goes away, it kills me because we don't do any live shows, we don't write any new music. It's just depressing. More than anything else, it's depressing to lose your friend for 9 months.
If anyone is the UK Eminem, it would be Skinny. He's really that good and he's really that raw. And I also think in some senses that he's got as much to do with potentially a Sean Ryder or Johnny Rotten. I think it's a real anti-hero that has an alternative story that's not going to be told what to do and has important stories to tell.
My life's inspiration is to do this music thing and build on that. What don't kill you can only make you stronger, and that's why I'm planning to be in this game longer than those little whippersnappers. They come and go rappers, blood. Are they forgetting that we're the dog's knackers? Dealing with those stick-up kids to kidnappers. Bring it to me now, you little push in my lackers. I hustle too hard for me to ever be a brackers. In London, the land of these young gun clappers, where it's mud for life and after the death. I'm ripping my defamation to the last of my breath. At this point, I've only got 6 bars left, but I feel there's much more shit for me to stress. To my poor unemployed who's down at the DSS, my peeps on the streets that are trying to progress. To the man them in jail with a couple years, yeah. This is the type of shit we have to manifest, the stress.
There we go, we're live. On a nice sunny day, what else to do other than come and have a nice little barbecue? I mean, for me, what's happened is I've had to pick from square one, come out in a homelessness situation with no money, no capital, no job prospects. And so I'm having to start from scratch and kind of build a life for myself again.
Don't you
bet. The side angle. Send me two times that, huh? Who suits that?
The school behind there that you see you built, it is recognised as the lowest achieving school on the whole of the curriculum in England. And that's it there, and that's the school I went to, except I was excluded within the first year. So most of my school years I spent right here on this park. The education board just let me slip through the system, I believe, and I suppose I was quite happy with that.
Hold on.
It was alive.
Coming from an environment like this, you have a good sense of community, because sometimes all you've got is the people you've got. You know, like, you ain't really got much to spread between you, but you've got each other. So what you've got, you've all got. Like you see today, we've got some food and we all ate, we've got some drink and we all drank, you know what I mean? Someone's got a little bit of cigarettes, a little bit of something to smoke, we're smoking, you know? It's like, that's how we live life, and in an area like this, something like that is very rare and unusual.
Oh my God, he's here.
What is that whole thing? You need a bigger roach than this, bro.
Sure, mate.
The most important thing for me is I do my lyrics for the people who you see around me, the people who mean something to me, who's going to come back to me and was like, yeah, I was feeling them lyrics and rah rah. So that's most importantly my main focus of who I want to reach out to, and I can do that and I am doing that, so I'm happy with where I'm at.
Yes, thank you.
Hey, you know what? I'm fucking sick to death with these feds, man. Harassing me, trying to pull me over, trying to take me off road. But you know what? Next time they're stopping me, I ain't running. I'm just a fucker.
Slough's situation is more settled. His family have moved away from the inner city to the leafy suburbs of North London.
This is me, man. This is like, I can just come and sit here. Bro, cushion on a chair, that's me.
I just crutch on this chair, white ass. And that's me right there.
Right there. This is my little vibe here. Many, many songs have been written in here.
Slough's hoping the move away from the estates will help him escape the temptations of crime and allow him to concentrate on his music.
So I come in here and it's just I'm away from the world, away from all the bullshit, and I can just concentrate. I'm in my own little world, I focus. As soon as I walk through that door there, I'm focused. And that's what it's about, focus and dedication. You gotta keep focused and you gotta be dedicated. And both of which I am. I got away from the gutter through my parents, and that sounds like some stupidness. You get me, like some little rich word. Right? My family's far from rich. And to get this, my mum and dad had to do some mad shit to get this property, you get me? And I'm just grateful that I've got my mum and dad there, like, because many of my friends haven't got what I've got. And I am grateful that I've got a mum and dad that have done well for themselves now. Like, they've got a nice house. It's not the best house, but it's a fair enough house. None of my brothers has got houses like this. So that's what I'm saying. It's like, I'm very grateful, you get me?
Just getting out here, and today, what do they think?
Oh, cool. No, they're cool with me smoking weed. It's a respect thing. I wouldn't like to smoke it in front of them. Understand me? Like, I smoke it in my room and shit, but it's a respect. I would never sit down and smoke a spliff in front of my mum and dad. It's just a respect thing, you get me? I respect my parents. They know the score, you get me? They're not stupid. They know about weed and that. Mum and dad have been so, it's unbelievable. The amount of trouble I've brought to my addresses through these years, it's unbelievable. How they've stuck by me, they've always supported me. Every time I've been to prison, they come and visit me every possible visit. Do you know what I mean? They've always been there for me, mum and dad. You get me? Always. They've always. I couldn't ask for a better set of parents.
For Skinny, home is wherever he ends up that night, but his lyrical inspiration comes from the estates he grew up on.
When you go behind the doors of the houses that you see on all of these estates that you're seeing, most people you're seeing are from people who's unemployed, find it hard for opportunities to work. We've got thousands of single parents. We've got thousands of children who are being excluded from school. You find that people are ready to take risks and do things and go to extremes to try and get out of the situations that they're in at the moment. Out of a million sad stories that you hear from people around here, you hear 10 successful stories, you know? So it's like 10 in a million is gonna make it around here and the other rest of us are gonna be left here, you know what I mean? Just trying to struggle on by. Generation as a youth, it was all about smoking drugs and getting stoned to alleviate the realities of around here. How I got into selling weed? Well, everybody was smoking around me and my mum's always been a smoker, and because everybody was getting off this regular guy and they had all had a credit off him, like a £10 tick. Everybody was sending me because I was the youngest, and it was like the rules as the youngest goes on the missions for the elders. And I'd be going back and forth with this guy all day, and I kind of realised if I bought my own big piece and chopped it up where they're sending me to him all day, I could be doing it for myself. And I suppose I just took the initiative from there. And since then I've saw that there's been a profit to be earned in it.
pays for your own bit of weed, which I enjoy smoking my own bit of weed, and yeah, you can buy the night trainers that cost 120, which you couldn't have bought before. I mean, my hunger to get where I want to get to is big, you know what I mean? And I think every day I want to strive like a frantic madman to get to where I want to get to until I get there. I want a comfortable level where I know I can have a nice house, a nice car, and money for the rest of my day, so I'll be financially comfortable to take a holiday every year, have some nice cable TV, you know, and just support my family, really.
Paul Martin, Skinny's ex-A&R man, is trying to get him a new deal. He's arranged a meeting at Sony to find out how realistic his chances are with the major labels.
My role with him is first and foremost as a friend and as someone that just wants to help him get his record done.
All right, no problem. All right, cool.
But at the end of the day, it's just really about doing whatever we can do to get the record done so that we can put something out there that represents something.
Yeah. Oh, look, we got Dave on the end.
We better get in because we only got long.
Yeah. What's going to happen today is probably some shitty little A&R man's going to chat some shit and nothing's going to happen. Standard UK hip-hop.
Yeah.
That's how it is, though. It's a piece of rock. Well, what happened? Right, but he said it's the realest shit there is. It's doing it. It's bomb. It's heavy. It'll never sell. Which is true, really. I mean, it's like the opposite of you sound crap, you look terrible, you go a long way. You look fantastic, you sound fantastic. No one will want you. You know what I mean, Pete? Yeah. What are we to do, man? So come on, boy. What are we saying? You strapping?
Right. Oh, it's interesting, he likes the shit, thinks you're good, thinks you're a star. I'm just questioning the amount of units that can be done. And nowadays these big companies...
What kind of units was he talking?
Well, he says, you know, we can do 50,000-60,000 records, not a problem. But to him, that's not enough to make money.
Did he say if we go around 300,000?
300,000, yeah, which I think is still achievable, so... I think it's odd, you know. I actually think he'll come back, it's funny enough.
300,000, piece cake, man.
Piece cake, yeah, it's simple.
I sell more weed than that, isn't it? No, we don't really. Joking.
The major's response to Skinny is a familiar one in the underground music scene. The only way to convince the major labels is to sell significant amounts of material recorded and released independently. Sloth is only too aware of how the system works. He's in his DJ's bedroom recording new material to release himself.
For the last few years, I've been getting told, yeah, you're getting signed. Not only by, like, it's by everyone. People, yeah, you're getting signed. Record labels said, yeah, this, like, people promise you things, but it don't happen. And that's what's made me want to do it myself. And that's what's made me see I can do it myself. Because I see so many people doing it, and I think, bruv, I could do it better than you. I could do what you're doing better than you. So that's why I'm doing it myself. I don't need no one else, really.
Another one that's made a new can rob a travel agent. Alarm poorly for the money, you're a Thomas Cook. And it hurts all these words in my mind, and I find this society that made me go and turn my life to crime.
Yeah, I had a job and it lasted for the whole of like 4 days. Like, it was alright, it was like a sales job, but nah. My first night I didn't finish till midnight, and I thought, fuck this. If this is what graft is, I ain't down with graft, bruv. I'm definitely not. If this was what people have to put up with, then I, you know what, yeah, there was dudes there, and I thought, you know what, I really respect you, mate. Because for you to come here at 10 o'clock in the morning and go home, like, at 12 o'clock at night, for what you're earning, you're a good man. I'm telling you, the best of luck to you and your missus. Have a happy life together. You know what I mean? Most of their fucking birds must have been laughing, man, like, getting all the money. Don't have to see their partners, just have another fella on the side. It weren't for me, serious tip, it weren't for me, like, the hours was crazy and I got other things to do. So, you know what I mean, I'm trying to sort things out, but I can't let it overtake my music because that'd just be stupid.
Another one that's
Slot's not finding his transition into the world of work easy, but he's convinced his mates that he does want to go straight.
This happens a lot, you know, flopping up.
I mean, the way I sit with him, I talk to him, like, he talks to me a lot, you know, I mean, I know he ain't going to go down that path again. I mean, if he does, it's just because something might have happened to him or whatever, but he wants to stay straight, he wants to be successful and whatnot, so I reckon he'll stay on a straight narrow now. He's learned his lesson now, so I say he's had his fingers burnt, and so, I mean, I don't think he's going to go back down that road again.
Where did they just go? Did I delete them?
I feel in music, yeah, that's the only way I've ever found that I can really express myself. It's like I could let out all the shit that was inside me from just like putting pen to paper. I would sit there and I would sit at the table and then like a couple of hours just sit in a dark room, fat spliff, boom, that, and I'd have a fat lyric. And it's just like, whoa. Sometimes I would surprise myself, I'd look back at some of the words I've used and I'm like, whoa, where did that word come from, man?
I feel knackered, mate, I'm telling you. It's been a long day, Joe, I tell ya.
Isn't an issue actually, everyone smoking weed. Everyone smokes so much weed.
Everyone does, it's just, I don't know, it's better than cigarettes, isn't it? It tastes better, like, I don't like blazing green just to get fucked up, but to get buzzed and shit. It's just, much like the taste of it. But everyone, like all the hardporters, everyone blazes. Just one of them things, really.
Because I don't care, this shit's addictive, you know? Man say it's not addictive, like it becomes a habit and you rely on it, yeah? But this new high-grade shit is addictive because I'm waking up in the morning like a cat. Like, meow, meow for a spliff. We know Sloth ain't no fucking cat because man's been stabbed 9 times, I've had 9 lives, so I definitely ain't a cat. We all know that Sloth ain't a cat. Get me 9 times and I still ain't dying.
Along poly for the money, you're a Thomas Cook. You're a crook, don't be shook. Just look at the dough we can earn. Wait your turn, it's still more than land.
Tell me what the words are all about.
It's a robbery thing, bruv. To survive. This is how you survive in the concrete jungle. This is it. This is how you survive. This is how most of my friends survive. If they're not selling drugs, they're robbing, and that's it. And it's not our fault, it's society's fault. Fuck society.
Slot's lyrics reflect the dark side of where he grew up, a world where stabbings were a regular occurrence. But now things have got more dangerous. Guns have become as commonplace as knives.
I chat to like young 15, 16 year olds and my brethren. They've got like sticks already. They're walking around with guns at like 15, 16. And like, I think back when I was 15 and 16, I weren't thinking about walking around with a gun and ending men. And like, people like don't understand why like people like myself have to do things on the street to like survive. But you don't know, you ain't living our life. Like, don't be judgmental on us, yeah? Because you don't know what it's like. You ain't living the life that we're living, you ain't walking in my shoes. I've had to walk the street with a gun. I wish I never, like, I feel like an idiot for how, but I'm not gonna make myself insecure about worrying about my life, like, by not carrying a gun. Like, and I know it's like dumb, like, I would never use it, I would never have pulled it out and said to someone, oh, like, just because I lost my temper. And unless somebody pulled one out of me, or unless someone went to stab me, or I wouldn't use it. I wouldn't. And I think like 50% of people who've got one are sensible like that. And I know it's not sensible having one, like it's stupid in the first place having one, you get me? But what are you to do? I'm not gonna let someone kill me. This year, I've lost 4 friends. 4 of my good friends have died this year. But it's taken like 4 friends of mine to die for me to really see. Like, it's, and for things like this to happen to myself, for me to really see like what's going on. And I don't like it, you get me? And music is my only way out of it. But that's how I feel, like, there's nothing I can do. There's nothing I can do apart from perform and make music to get out of the system. Like, to be someone else, not to be a sheep.
You're making some bricks on these estates, man, I'll try and get you. So you run, grab your butt.
Skinny still hasn't had any comeback from the majors. So like Sloth, he's recording a 12-inch to put out himself.
Do a little bit of a lead-in for the start of the top of the first verse.
blood, I'm not saying that I'm anything. Who am I to give man advice? It's not that I know best when trust blood, I don't. All I know is if you're coming from this manner I'm from, you'll find enough man or
patient. Lyrics are about youth of my day kind of having a kind of level of moral conduct when it came to certain aspects of street crime. Certain people used to say, oh, I would never rob a woman or try and steal a handbag off a woman. And some of those same people, a couple of years later, addicted on Class A drugs with habits that they feel they need to support. And they'll do anything, especially robbing a woman's handbag, you know? Things much more worse that they would have considered in their younger day to be atrocious and unacceptable. They'd be willing to commit those kind of crimes now, merely to support the habit that they've obtained.
Yo. Hmm?
To help record the single, Skinny's brought in up-and-coming producer, Baby J.
You'd be better to just say certain bits and try and get like that. I'm going to keep them low anyway, because your lead's strong.
Baby J is a producer that's been around for a long time. He's done his own stuff as well as working with a lot of established artists on the hip-hop field.
Now you've done it because you're riding a life up. Stop.
The second one, you felt it. The first one, you was rapping.
I'm happy to work with him because I get the raw feeling of essence of hip-hop and what it is to me to get that Nick jerk snapping feeling and that adrenaline feeling of me wanting to rap on the track. Where the track to me is like, let me put something on this.
That are all sitting hating. The jealous ones are always envy, so you're there saying, nah, who wants it? Let them come and spite ya. You had to get them, so they get you first.
Sorry, last line I skizzed up on.
I think the reason that you haven't really heard a single out from Skinny Man is because every time his career is about to really jumpstart, he seems to be disappearing as and going, AWOL, you know what I mean? So, doing his little stints and whatnot. So I think that's basically been a hindrance.
Everybody's on their own little hustle just to find a way to try and get through.
I think there's going to be opportunities open to him and there's going to be sales open to him because he's white.
So you're gonna grab your bucket.
Young white kids, who is the predominant buying audience, basically are kind of fascinated by black culture, but I think when they see a white person involved with it, I think they kind of associate with it more, kind of like, yo, that could be me.
So what's the record for the madness? For any of these kids who get left out on these streets, will you find everybody?
And even though Skinny's, you know, been involved in certain things and been around street life from whatever age, it's still going to be easier for a white kid to think he's on a level with him than it is to think he's on a, you know, the same kind of level as certain black artists doing the same kind of music.
Hating, the jealous ones will always envy, so you're there saying now who wants it? Let them fucking spite ya. They're out to get you, so you get them first. And look, now you've done it because you're riding a lighter.
I'm just loving this. I'm not yes. Can I hear it once more?
Sloth's on bail after being grassed up by a former business acquaintance. He's been trying to avoid trouble, but this is one issue he can't let go.
He got me arrested like last month, so I think it's about time we come to pay him a little visit. So we're gonna go and see what he's saying.
Sloth's still facing charges resulting from his last visit here.
The last time I come here, I come on my own as I have gone today, and he was sitting in there with like three of his bedrooms and two chicks. He started like chucking his mouth behind the gate. He wouldn't come out the gate though. His bedrooms were in there laughing. He wouldn't come out the gate. So I said, you know what? Fuck you. Yeah, I've had enough of you. Like, you're a cunt. I went downstairs and somebody, I don't know who it was, like I ain't got a clue who it was, but somebody smashed his car up and tried to set fire to his car. I don't know, I didn't see no one do it. And the police got called and he got me arrested. I was just basically coming to talk to him today and asking why he phoned the police and why he got me arrested for them things, because I didn't do these things. Was it me? Now man's gonna have to pay the prices for what he done, like man being a grass. It's a serious thing, it's a serious issue. I don't deal with it lightly.
Are you out on bail at the moment?
Mm.
You are?
Mm. Yeah.
On what charge?
Attempted aggravated burglary, criminal damage, driving without taxing insurance, just minor things like that. And I had a warrant for my arrest. Anyway.
We're just talking there. And we see a man in the door. And he's seen me standing there. And he's tried to come in to that height like that. Run after him. And he's got into another block over there. And got into another flat. I don't know whose flat it is. But he's just left me straight there. I'm not forgetting all the crimes that we're heading to the self-claim heaven's hiding in the. But he's standing out the window. Look, see my man at the window. He's led me straight to the yard. This is grimy.
Danger! Yo, danger! Where is he? Where? Oi, danger, I'm not going nowhere today. I'm waiting for you, fucking cunt. Yeah, you can't. There's danger in there.
Who?
Danger. No?
No.
Alright, so far away from.
Yeah,
I will.
You don't come to my house,
alright? Well, don't let him come to your house, innit? Don't let him bring trouble to your house. Don't let him run into your house bringing trouble to your house. We've got little kids in there as well. Don't let him do that. He's a cunt.
Don't you come knocking
at my door. Yeah, fuck off.
I'm shit out of my kids, do you understand me?
What, the police will be here in a minute. You'll probably call the fucking police again, a dirty cunt. Trying to act like a big man. Can't play in the big man's leagues though. Fucking idiot. See, this is how life is, man. This is how my life used to be every day. Dealing with fuckers like this, man. I'm glad I'm not dealing with this life no more. I wish I could put this shit to rest and just say, oh look, that's it, I've done with everything, but I can't. Like, I try and go to sleep at night and fucking danger's on my head, like, fucking with my mind, it's eating me away. I cannot let that happen. Once it's gone, yeah, the ghost will rest. Once danger's dealt with, the ghost will fucking rest, but it won't rest. And I need, it's stressing me out, I need to make this fucking ghost rest. It's doing my nut. You know, it sounds like I'm stupid and, like, I don't care if he's got a gun. I know danger, yeah, and I know even when you put a dog in the corner, the dog's bite, but man's a chow wow, little fucking poodle, he won't bite. He ain't got the balls to pull the trigger. I know any cunt can pull one, but this guy's a special cunt.
But it's not only Sloth who's fallen out with Danger.
But what did Danger go shot for?
Stupid as that.
And I'm like, what? I'm like, you're a grass, bro.
In my house, isn't it?
See, this is what I'm talking about, what we were talking about earlier, yeah? Like, the guy started phoning people up, yeah, saying, yeah, like, Sloth's getting me a gun, like, he can get me this, he can get me that.
Yeah.
And that's what caused all the friction, like, that's what I'm saying. I've never met this guy before, yeah, I just met him today, yeah?
Yeah.
And, like, he knows about, like, all this madness, about this is the kind of guy Danger is, you get me? The guy's a proper fool, man.
He is, man.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, have you got a phone? Take my number, and when he's back in his yard, phone me, and I'll sort you out, innit? I'll sort you out some food, man.
Food?
Yeah, some green, innit?
Oh, right, yeah.
Cool, Bridget. Cool. Safe, yeah, take care, nice meeting you, bye. They're just young kids doing their thing, trying to help me, it's nice. It's nice to see this community spirit. It's good, man. Feel it. Definitely feel it.
Any MC trying to make a name for himself has to get a slot on a pirate station. Slot's been developing his unique style with his crew on North London's Raw Mission FM.
So, hey, phone line numbers are getting through tonight, you know. 07931 5.
6, 7.
Right, this is Raw Mission. I've been on here for like what? I think it's like 3 years nearly now.
We just Raw Missions right now. And this today is with Raw Mission 9000.
Bad station in London basically, yeah. I've got to say that.
5, 6, 7, level 3, 1 gets you through tonight.
I've had the same show for about 2.5 years, like 8 to 10 Sunday, Raw Mission. So it's live, man. You get me? People get to hear your voice. It's like they come familiar with you. Like it's either they feel your crew, they don't. It's like there's loads of different like levels in the market. Like of what people feel. Like some people feel like proper agginess. Some people don't really feel the agginess. So like, it's mad. Like the scene's going like mad different ways. Like it's hard to see where the scene's going.
A whole morning period, pretending she's a virgin, cause I know that you're feeling it.
Technically, it's illegal, so that's why it's called pirate, like a pirate radio station. You get me? Steve.
Okay. Yo, yo, yo. From 9 years ago and thing, I've just been getting better all the time. I get better, I just keep getting better, excelling, trying to get better, better, better all the time. I don't even think I'm at my best yet. Still got time. When that time comes, it's over. Straight up. Straight up. Fucking straight up.
You can't really get on a legal station, like you can't really get on Choice or One Extra or nothing if you haven't got any like fan base. They're not just gonna let anyone on the big stations like that. But so like people coming up have to use the underground, like the pirate radios
Pirates
or whatever
central, man.
To get bigger.
Best in this, I chose to be the best in this. I chose to be the best in this. With my rap and with my rhythm, I chose to be the best in this.
We're the click. We're promoting ourselves to go on the radio. So more listeners feel us, more and more. Every week they get to know us, they start to know our lyrics. So then when we start getting booked in venues, then people will know our lyrics. So when we get on stage, they'll be able to bust our lyrics with us at the same time. From when you reach them stages, that's when you know like people are starting to feel
your
shit.
Feel
like that.
Yeah, for real.
And then that's when it all starts blowing from there. Then you can start making the dubs, start, you know, try and make album, and just try to promote yourselves, get me? So that's what we're doing, promoting, just promoting, trying to get lineups, trying to make some dough.
And it's slow for y'all, but this shit, and I'ma kill you, bro. I'ma just hold you right now, it's Raw Mission 9000, and the Grime's just starting, ain't nothing yet, bro. Okay, we're all tied to free girl then, and it's Mr. Basil right now. I'm rolling.
The shit I've been making, I don't think there's anyone on road who's making shit like me. I'm just being real, man. When I hear this shit, like, it's live, man. Big up everyone who's doing things in the garage scene. I'm not hating on no one, it's live. Like, feel your shit, but better be scared, man, because I'm coming, you know? Far from the game.
For Skinny, the next step in his comeback is to perform in front of a live audience.
We're in Cambridge, Raw Organic, where it looks like it should be a lively crowd tonight. I believe we have a bit of a fan base up here. Considerably to say that, yes, they probably know the words to the lyrics.
Nah, I've not heard of them before, mate.
Wait, tell her, girl, boy, all that sort of shit.
Not much, just that he's good.
If you're into hip hop in general, you should be into Skinny, man, you know what I mean?
Like when he raps, it's like he paints a picture, a verbal picture, and I'm really feeling it, and I want to see stuff in the shops.
So if my shit's gonna blow, this might just be my chance to see my life change. Fix up my aims, fix up my games, find the weakest links in the chain. Sick of living every day here the same amongst all the cats who's all on cocaine. Pretty little girls who turn on the game on the streets with the peeps who don't use their name. Let us take a trip down memory lane and see how shit is now.
Yeah, I film you. I'll film you, you bitch.
Why you talking to me, bitch?
Did you call me a bastard, you cunt?
Yeah!
Hey, look, you fucker. Look, you fucking cunt. Look, you fucking cunt. I'll make a film with you now, you cunt.
Skinny's reputation means there's always other rappers who want to battle him.
Yeah,
that made me vomit. Don't you realise? You can grab a can of cider and vomit, but you're still not going to come as strong as lightning. That's why I'm the kind of MC that can do it.
His name's Danny, but he wants to lose his life. I don't know why he's really running it up tonight. You got Bright, you're smoking a crack pipe. Are you like a fiend? I know that they come out at night. Supreme being, well, that's not what I'm seeing. A human being that's about to be dead. Don't worry, like the
you got MCs that want to come up and they think if I can step to Skinny Man on the battle tip and beat him, and I can kind of put a notch under my belt and say, well, I've had a battle with Skinny Man and I won him. And so you're always going to have MCs who's going to want to come up and battle.
Hey, Danny, that's
let's face it, mate, you might be writing some fancy checks, but we all know you're wearing some kid size Averex. I know it's some denim thing that you're rocking tonight. But you're trying to get into this, but you can't really fight. On the battle thing, you're going to lose because you're going to choose to go against the best Danny Life's man that can come through and test even Skinny.
Listen, you're trying to come skinny with some nice but words, but you don't know that gloms like this blood, they're icebergs. And you can rhyme all night, all the time, but everyone knows you get crushed with one line. That's it. Go home. Go home.
On stage, it's a good adrenaline feeling. You have the butterflies thinking, yeah, the nerves are on, or at least for me they are. You know, I'm still nervous. I still wanna do the show to the best of my ability without making any mistakes and please the crowd.
Are you ready for the grime shit? Yeah. Any nation, so we need to be great and tap out your patience.
With some of my material, I write it so that I get a feedback from the audience, so I can kind of play with the audience and they can fill in words that they'll be familiar with and stuff like that. Really, all I want from the audience is their undivided listening attention, really, you know, to get the message through what the lyrics are in the songs.
Hold that.
It's the after feeling when you're finished and you're getting an applause for a tune that you've done, and you're just kind of coming off stage and people was like, yeah, I was really feeling that, and that's when you kind of think, yeah, that's what it was all about.
But that obviously wasn't me, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we're in there.
How long is it going to be now until you go back? Can you actually stay out for a little while?
I say it till about next summer.
You'll be lucky.
I'll be lucky.
Do you actually like it though? Is that why you go back?
I don't mind it though.
Because I used to go out.
Oh yeah?
Because I used to go out with a guy who was in prison for all sorts of crazy
institutionalised mentality.
Yeah, no, but he actually was like,
I don't want to go back.
He quite liked it.
I don't want to go back. I don't want
to
go back.
Some people can get quite used to it. Like, it's the same favour.
I'm used to it. It's not everywhere.
The problem is with us and the fans is that he's only out for a certain amount of time, which doesn't mean that he can have enough time to put out records and all that kind of stuff.
There's a bunch of us young MCs trying to come out, and Skinny is one of the people that you just have no choice, you just have to look up, man. It's the only thing I can say.
Got a great response from the crowd and great feedback and interaction with the crowd, you know what I mean? So, yeah, man, I felt it. It's been great so far. Cuts. Yeah, good night, God bless. Shiggity.
And as you rob, you can get robbed. Today we're gonna talk about robberies. Robberies are fuckeries. Normally when somebody is suffering from gluttony, but obviously sometimes we're hungry. So really doing robbery.
Things have been looking up for Sloth. He's recorded a new batch of tracks which all the pirate stations are playing.
Nah, I ain't fucking about no more. I've told you what I'm coming to do and I've done it. And this year, it's my year, and I've said that, and it's gonna be my year, and it's happening. I've got three tracks out at the moment, just on dubplate, just different DJs. And it's like, the comeback I'm getting off the tracks is amazing. I'd never expected it, never, in a million years. Especially off these tracks, they're all good tracks, but not. I didn't expect the kind of feedback I'm getting, you get me? So it's good, and it's exciting at the moment. So, fingers crossed, things are just gonna keep getting better, man. You know what, I've got so many tracks, it's stupid. So stupid.
And my tracks are better than anyone's out there. So, you fucking other dudes might as well quit now.
But Sloth's criminal past is proving hard to leave behind.
I got arrested twice in 1 week. I got nicked on a... First time I got nicked, it was a Friday. I got bail, they didn't charge me, it was cool. I got bail on a Friday. And then I get nicked Tuesday for something that happened like 5 months ago, like on a robbery or something that I have not got a clue about. Like, people say I'm involved in a robbery that I don't even know about, you know what I'm saying? But so I got nicked for that, and then I got out, and that's about my last week, really. That's just what's happening for me. Just the same old smeg, man. Do something positive, and then the negative hits you right back. Oh, shit. I think I'm meant to be at court today. No way. One second. Idiot.
Would you like a cup of tea?
What's the date today?
It's the 29th.
This was on the 17th, this thing, you know?
Where is it?
That court date.
Oh, yeah, I'm in trouble.
I want to see a picture of my sister's for,
wow,
man.
Oh, that's... Yeah, man.
That's Lucy. Told you she loves the camera. Camera loves her.
Come on, this ain't coming out on camera, Dave.
Wow. She's very pretty,
isn't
she? Beautiful. That means, but that's stupid, because then they would have nicked me for this, then can't be my charges.
What is it?
Some stupidness, bruv. Basically, to do with that danger scenario. Basically, prep danger. You know that grass we were talking about danger before? You know the dude's house he went to? The grass, him. To do with him.
The police patrol the streets like beasts. Instead of chasing the thieves, they pull him up and give them beats. So kids run the streets red. He's holding his head as he's just driving around on a stolen ped. The police told the cards that life dealt them. Half of his crew are now locked down in Feltham. Screws and probation can't seem to help them. The laws made sure that they've grown to resent them. So now you can't ask what their life's representing. To get through the day is their sole intention. And you can't tell him that he's wrong, cause he's a man child who feels he knows what's going on. He ain't got no time to enjoy life being young or having fun. He's got to keep it headstrong. You can't really talk about words to advise him. He look at you as if your words are patronizing. He can't think about no long-term plans when he's a young boy trying to be one of the man's them. Can't think about long-term plans when he's a young boy trying to be one of the man's them. See?
Despite recording new material and doing successful PAs, Skinny still doesn't have a deal, a job, or even a permanent home.
He's on it. Give it to them.
Skinny hits the streets of Camden, Itchy Town, looking for distractions.
It's Itchy Town because the town is itchy, the people are grimy and the streets are gritty.
The hopes he had of signing with another label haven't come to anything. Skinny's starting to lose faith that he'll ever get his record deal back again.
The deal's over, man, there ain't no deal. Do you really think any major industry in England wants to take a chance on putting money onto a little youth who's representing for the voice of the ghetto in an urban environment? They're not interested, let's not kid ourselves. Hello.
Skinny's hopes that a record deal would give him a legal income have come to nothing. But he still needs money to live on.
Yeah!
A lot of people in society that are in my predicament are caught in a vicious circle who seem to only, like, when it all goes to the floor and you have to go all out for gusto, like, to go for what you know, what can you get, where are you gonna get to eat? A lot of people turn to the wrong elements and aspects of life.
Mad family, come, let's get the bennies.
Yeah, you got some food, right?
He's got everything.
I'm willing to work hard, you know what I mean? But it's hard. I'm working hard and I'm still not getting nowhere, you know? So I don't know, it's confusing.
Yo, since I've been in America.
You know, because I'll admit, I feel like I'm in a mess and I feel very depressed in my life right now, you know what I mean?
America!
That's all.
That is all!
That's all.
What am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? I'm just gonna hope for the best.
Oh, Jesus!
Sloth's bought himself some fancy footwear. Today's the day he spent all year working towards.
Right, basically what's happened is Paulie Dawes from my manager, like they've got to hear some of my music and they're feeling my shit, yeah? So they've contacted my manager and I've tried to arrange a meeting to put a face to the music, you get me?
Potential of this is like if they really like him, hopefully they give him £1 million and an album deal. But realistically, hopefully if they'll like him, you know what I mean, they'll push him and show some interest and he can get a step further in his career.
I ain't coming in here thinking anything. I'm just coming here thinking they've heard my music, they're feeling it, see what they got to say, innit? But I ain't standing for no bullshit. I've done something from day one. If A&R chat shit to me, I'm going to spit in their face and bowl. So, well, one that's going to happen. If they try and show me any disrespect, I'm just going to show my finger and it'd be an early meeting. Roll, man, let's roll.
Slow, tell me what happened.
It's all good in the hood, isn't it?
Nah, they're hating in a way. Nah, don't be stupid, they love me.
They love me, innit? They want to give me shit, they want me to do shit, put shit out for me already. They just met me now and they want to put shit out for me.
Don't let our world know yet.
Let's roll, innit? Let's walk anywhere. I don't like standing in front of there, man.
They're playing cool, but they're giving good signals. Man's happy anyway, put it that way.
It's cool, man. They've said that they're willing to do shit anyway, straight away, you get me? That they're feeling it.
What does that mean though?
I don't know.
That means we gotta talk business.
We gotta talk business, innit? We gotta talk dough and shit, innit? But that's all long for the minute anyway, man, because there's so many more meetings that man's gotta go to and people that have been phoning and bugging to talk to us, so we'll see, innit? See why I blow. If you don't dream, you don't win nothing, man. I'm serious. So just shows you, man. Someone like who comes from my background and who's lived a life like I've lived can still achieve shit. Shows, you get me? But obviously you've got to have talent and shit. You can't just be some bum off road. No, but you know what I mean? I'm just joking. That was just a bit of Sloth hate there coming in. Yeah, man.
Sloth's had to change his designer shoes for his best suit. Today he's in court on a series of charges that could see him sent to prison. If the magistrate decides against him, his potential record deal could go the same way as Skinny Man's did.
See your two fat fingers, they're saying not guilty, motherfucker. I know them stupid fuckers in there thought I was gonna be standing like this today, but no, man. You see these fingers can't stop standing up today. It's like they've got erections or something. There's some real blood running through that finger right there, man. Fucking cunts. Serious. I got into court, and basically they just went straight onto the driving offences, right? So I'm not saying nothing, and I'm just like, wow, what's going on here? Like, why have they not talked about anything else? Like, they're talking about the minor issues when they should be, when normally they leave the minor issues to last. They leave that as like the, oh, well, and this kind of thing. The magistrate's just gone, is there anything else like relating to the case? Because there's, I've got notes here relating to the case. Is there anything else that should be read out? Like, and that's when I thought, oh, fucking, wow. Like, there's going to be something else. And I'm sitting there and I'm like, ah, oh, this is it now. He's going to read them out now, blah, 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 blah. And he's gone, no, that's it. He was pulled over on Woodhouse Road. I had armed police. That's how deep it was. Armed police lay me on the floor. Lay me on the floor. Get out of the car. Lay me on the floor. That's how deep it was. Not pull me over. I drove out to the road. The road was closed off. That's how deep it was. You get me? So I'm thinking, like, okay. And that's when the smile started, like, just creeping. I could feel the smile. I couldn't stop it. It was like someone had some string, cut some holes and was pulling it. I couldn't stop the smile coming. I was like, don't smile. They're going to think you're happy. Don't smile. So then, basically, got the little slap in the wrist, the case got a jam to 4 weeks, and I was like, yeah!
Wait, fuck that shit, stop it, yo! The feds is coming, boys ain't running. I'ma do the movie thing and stand here popping. Cause I ain't going back to jail, and I got warrants. So I'ma stay here and roll, cause prison life is bollocks. The feds is coming, boys ain't running. I'ma do the movie thing and stand here popping. Cause I ain't going back to jail, and I got warrants. So I'ma stay here and roll, cause prison life is bollocks. Do you know how it feels to pop with people restart?
This is the start. It's all going good for me. It's going to plan. But this ain't even a fraction. This ain't even a small, tiny little decimal of what's going to happen. Serious. The fun ain't begun yet, man.
And you know what? I'm fucking sick to death with these feds, man, harassing me, trying to pull me over, trying to take me off road. But you know what? Next time they're stopping me, I ain't running.
Sloth has managed to stay out of trouble and is making music every day. Record labels are showing a real interest.
Putting the guy in his head and just...
Crazy. But he'll only believe it when the contracts have been signed. Skinny was arrested for possession of cannabis and spent 4 weeks in Pentonville awaiting trial. The charges were dropped when the case went to court, and at last he was able to finish his first album.